Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be how to sort of like cope with results day stress. Obviously, I know the level results day has just gone. However, GCSE results day is on Thursday. So, what better time to give this video than
for GCSE students? Because obviously exam GCSE results day is
supposedly stressful, or at least it's more stressful for others than it is for others. And I just thought I'd give you some tips on how to reduce that stress, slash de-stress, or whatever. And so, without further ado, let's get into these tips.
Tip number one.
Pamper yourself. Put on a face mask, foot mask, hair mask, exfoliate and tan, whatever you want to do, pamper yourself. When you put on like a fresh face mask and you pamper your skin, it makes you feel good and it makes it turns your mind to something else. Like, that's the main thing, is you need to turn your mind to something else. The fact that you're worrying about exam results means that you're not doing anything.
It means that you've not got anything to do.
And so, by pampering yourself, you're doing something that's taking your mind off of that. Whether it's you're exfoliating, ready to
put on a new time, because you know that you've got to concentrate when you're
putting on that tan, otherwise it will get all over your bed sheets, and that's not going to be happy. And your mother isn't going to be happy with
the bed sheets
she's going to have to wash.
So, yeah, pamper yourself.
Number two, know that it's not the end of the world, and I can speak from this personally. I failed at GCSE
originally. I went through the whole
stage of, oh my god, I'm going to have to retake my GCSEs. And I stressed about it. However, having to retake that GCSE has done me a whole lot of favour, because now I know what I want to do with my life. Whereas when I originally applied to college, I applied to law, psychology and sociology.
This past year, I've done
sociology and psychology
at GCSE.
As much as I like the subjects, I don't want to continue with them.
And so this year has worked to my benefit. Just know that
things happen for a reason. Things are timed for a reason.
If you're religious, then
what I'm about to say, I'm kind of going to steal from Jess Conti and like Gabriel Conti, but God has his timings. God times things perfectly. And if you're a religious person, then God didn't make you pass that exam for a reason. You might not know what that reason is, you might never know what that reason is, but he's done that for a reason. And it might be that when you start uni, you meet
your future, you meet the person you're going to marry,
the person who's going to be the parent, the other parent of your children. God has his reasons, and even if you're not religious,
the universe has its reasons. Don't
panic. Things happen for a reason. And just know that it's not the end of the world. A piece of paper.
It doesn't define you. Also, if you keep seeing me looking down, it's because I've written my
notes. Yeah, a piece of paper doesn't define you. Don't stress about it. There are always options. Tip number three. Have a shower slash bath. This goes along with the pampering. Like, you're just, like, when you take a bath in, like, hot water, hot soapy water, it's a muscle reliever, but it's also, like, you're relaxing, and again, relieve stress.
That's what you want to do. You want to relieve your stress. You don't want to make yourself
panic over it. So yeah, take a bath, have a shower, whether that means singing in the shower, whatever. Do it. If it makes you happy, do it. That's all I can say. Tip number 4. Spend time with friends. Spending time with friends means you're obviously not spending time alone. When you spend time alone, you have more depressing thoughts. So if you spend time with friends, then you're going to be talking, you're going to be laughing. Yeah, you might touch on the subject of exams and how worried you are, but they're always there to support you,
to motivate you, and that's what they're going to do.
I know with my friends, like, we were talking about exams, at, like, the exam results day, like, this was last year, and one friend, she was like, I'm going to fail. I don't know, I think it was like Spanish or something. She was like, I'm going to fail Spanish or whatever. And I was like, no, you're not. You do really well and that sort of thing. Actually, no, I think it was more geography. I think it was geography. But she was worrying about failing geography and all of that. And I was just constantly saying, no, I know you've done all right. You're incredible at geography. Don't worry about it. You've got this. I was constantly having to say something along the lines of that to her. But yeah. Spend time with friends, whether that's just sort of window shopping, do it, whether that's watching highlighters or shimmery eyeshadows, which me and my friend did. This was pre-prom, but still. I think we did that afterwards, but yeah. Or whether it's going out for a meal, or whatever, like a meal with your friends, whatever. Again, like, the main thing of this is do something that takes your mind off of the fact you've got results day. Tip number 5, I don't know what I'm doing here, be creative, whether that's writing a short story or a novel, painting a picture, colouring, doing like arts and crafts. Whether that's writing a song or singing a song, or whether that's creating a new piece of like fashion for yourself, or a cross stitch, or whatever. Like, do something to be creative
that means
your mind is going to be focused on something else. Your mind is going to be in the depth of writing this story about, I don't know, Clarence and the time machine or whatever, and you're going to be so deep and delve, and you can, and you'll delve into this character and developing him or her and their backstory and the protagonist, and whether they're the protagonist, whether there's a villain, what's going to happen in the story, and writing that story is going to make you
a lot more creative. Or in fact, even creating a YouTube video, like, not
this one exactly, but creating a YouTube video,
like, whether that's arts and crafts,
or whether that's an advice video, whether it's a talkative, like giving your advice on a topic in the world, whether that's, I don't know, you posting a cover if you're really good at singing,
or maybe an ASMR video, I don't know, something creative that
just takes up your time. Tip number 6, do your makeup. I know when I do my makeup, it's like really relaxing, and I can be like, even though the makeup routine I've got is like the same, it's like quite creative, and it's like when you're bronzing and just like making sure it looks seamless and effortless and taking that time to perfect your craft is just insane. I love doing makeup and I find it relaxing. And like, even if you're not leaving the house and you're just staying at home, makeup is great to do. Like, doing your makeup is amazing, or whether you get a friend round
and do their makeup.
as a laugh, or get them to do your makeup. Yeah. Yeah. Tip number 7, go for a walk / be active. Now, you obviously hear, like, stories about, like, well, not stories, about how people say that the reason why they exercise is to relieve stress. So, it's obviously going to relieve exam day stress, or pre-exam day stress. So, exercise, whether that's going to the gym, even if it's, like, buying a day pass, doing an at-home workout, going for a run, walking the dog, whatever. And, like, dogs are great stress relievers. They give you so much love. And, yeah. Go for a walk / be active. Talk to somebody. Obviously, this goes along with friends stuff. Like, talking to friends and, like, being with friends. However, talking to someone could be,
I don't know,
parents, relative, family friend, or maybe even seeking the advice of a therapist. There are going to be so many great therapists out there. I don't know of any, like, organisations or anything, but there are also going to be, like, stress helplines. And so, you probably won't realise this, but I've actually just, like, the other day, I updated my description, and in there are links to, like, hotlines, like, mental health hotlines, and I think some of them, like, one or two of them were stress related, and if I haven't included them on there, there's a link for the extra ones, and so, and one of the links is to a page that has all the, like, mental health hotlines and everything, so obviously that's going to be extremely helpful, and so, I would, if you are struggling and you want to talk to somebody that's a complete stranger, because sometimes talking to a complete stranger
can help more than,
and seem
better than talking to
somebody you know, then go and check out my description and the links in my description. Or maybe you don't want, or maybe let's say you don't want to call up and talk to somebody, but you don't want to talk to family, then my email is in the description box. If you want to email me, then email me. I will read, I will respond, and if you ask me a question about your advice on something, then I will answer back as best as I can.
Obviously knowing it is my own advice, so
my own advice might possibly not be the best for you, so take it
with a pinch of salt,
or take it as a suggestion. And this doesn't just relate to exam day stress, it relates to anything in life,
whether it's a relationship. Like, I've never been in a relationship, but I could probably give,
okay, relationship advice. Like, I don't know why, but I just seem to be able to give, okay, relationship advice. So message me about that. Anything that's going on at home, family-wise, message me.
Well, email me, should I say.
And, yeah, And if for whatever reason you wanted
me to turn it into, like, an agony aunt section on my channel,
I'm okay with that. But if not, and you want to keep it between us two, perfectly fine. I'm not bothered about an agony aunt, like, sort of video. But it was just me saying, like, if people wanted me to talk about it on my channel, if they thought, like, it's something something important to be talked about, because they think
many people are going through it, then.
Yeah. I have no clue what number we're on. We are on, should I say, but listen / watch ASMR or listen to music. Now, I don't know whether you know this, but
I actually have an ASMR channel. I will leave it linked in the description box.
And I create ASMR content. At the moment, I'm putting this channel first, at least for the next week anyway, because I've got so much content I need to film and edit it, and so little time,
because I kind of left it to the last minute a little bit,
which is why I'm filming this at night, and the next video will be filmed after this. But yeah.
And obviously listening to music, listen to your favourite band, or discovering new music.
Apparently classical music is supposed to be nice. Don't know. But yeah, listening to music and obviously listening to ASMR. Like if you listen to it, like, and you get like tingles or like a relaxing sensation from auditory triggers, then obviously listen to it. But if you get triggers from visuals, then watch it. That's why I'm saying listen or watch. But people's whispers or soft spoken or like tapping or, I don't know, scratching, people obviously find relaxing and relaxing relieves stress. Next tip is tidy your room. Now, there's probably going to be many of you out there that are groaning at that. However, we spend time to make your room spotless or almost spotless. You're putting your effort into thinking, oh, where does this go? Where does this go? Where should I put this? And that sort of thing. And you're not thinking about your upcoming exam results. And it's obviously going to be
great for you.
Next tip is bake or cook something. Now, baking, quite fun, tasty. Cooking, again, tasty and like tasty.
And you can obviously try new recipes, new things. Things can be a complete fail
or what, but bake or cook something really fun to do. You can do it with a friend, you can do it with a parent or a sibling, and it's just really fun to do. And yeah, okay, now my last and final tip is to do the cipher challenge. And some of you are probably thinking, what the hell is the cipher challenge? Well, basically it's a challenge set up by a university, I can't remember which one, and basically you get given like code, and new code is released each week as the challenge duration is on, and you have to work to decipher that challenge, and then you have to type the deciphered text into, like, I guess the answer box, and then you have to submit it, and you then get to go on to do the next week's set of code, and as the weeks go on, the code gets harder. Now, I tried this in, like, I first tried this, I want to say 2016, I think, and I did it with a group of friends who, like, I'd have talked to for, like, I'd have hanged out with before results day, like, 2018.
And basically, I did it in a group with them. We did. Okay. I think some people managed to get to, like, 5 or something.
Could be wrong, but then I tried to do the, like, earlier in the year, I tried to do, I think, the 2019 one on my own, and that's how far I got on the first one, but only because I didn't continue with it. Like, I actually have the pictures, like, that flash the screenshots. I don't know why I'm doing that, because I have got screenshots of the coded text, and I'd pretty much deciphered it. So far, it said the signs were subtle and it took me a while to spot them, but gradually I started to make them out, and like one of those old-fashioned WD pictures that springs into focus when you cross your eyes and count to 100. The truth crystallized and I realized that I had been searching for it all along, and then I put it wasn't. I'd guess it. Is WD pictures. I don't know what WD pictures are, but
yeah. And
to be honest, I kind of want to continue on with that, but once I've gotten through the stress of filming so much content this week, yeah.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video,
and I hope you guys found it useful. If you did, let me know in the comment section, like, which tip are you gonna do, or which tips are you gonna do, or whether this helped you, or whether you, or if there's anything you think I missed, then comment them down in the comment section below for people who like to read
the comment section whilst
watching, and subscribe if you haven't already. Like this video, get this to 10 likes, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!